We're here to build a miniature aquaponics system. We've bought all our materials, so let's get going. Now that we've constructed our structure, we are going to go ahead and plumb our plants and our fish component into the system. You'll see here I've got one of the plant grow beds. These are prefabricated now. We have our outflow from the plants, 3-inch pipe into a 1-inch elbow, our 5.5-inch, 1-inch diameter PVC pipe coming through our Uniseal gasket. And these containers are going to sit right inside of each one of these boxes. You'll see this is all going to connect together right here. We have 1-inch elbow into a 3-inch piece of PVC, another elbow connecting here to our 15-inch piece. We have another drain here through that T to another T, and all this is draining together down this pipe. We have an elbow over to where the tank's going to be sitting, an elbow over to where the into the tank again, and then the elbow down directing the water into the tank. We'll push these components together and this purple part should disappear, and that primer in there is going to give us a really good and tight connection whenever we dry fit these together. So you can see here there's a little bit smaller of a gap, and as we come down there's a little bit larger gap, and you come down a little further there's an even larger gap. So that means that our pipes are going to be a little bit different heights, and because we cut all these at the same length, all 3 inches, we should be able to get just that slight fall that we need in order for the water to drain properly. So now we have plumbed our outflow side. Now we have our inflow side. We're going to install that. This end will go to the pump, and there will be a hose off of that. And then these three valves are going to be installed right here in the center. And there's already a little hole cut in each one of these. So we're going to tie those in with some cable ties or zip ties, and we'll be able to have this all installed as one piece. Now we're installing our vinyl tubing. We're going to feed this up through the corner in here, underneath, in between. That's going to come right up. And notice I went ahead and put on my hose clamp. That'll save us a little bit of time here and frustration. Get it all the way up, snugged up as much as you can. We'll use our 5/16-inch nut driver to attach our hose clamp and put it right up here by the collar. Now we can take each one of these zip ties that we've inserted here and kind of line up our piece. Go ahead and just tighten those on down. We can flip them down, get them kind of out of the way for now. So we're going to install our fish tank, and we're going to get all of our plumbing connected up to that. We're going to insert it from the front. Make sure that the tank is supported directly on top of these wood pieces. And then whenever we fill it up with water, it'll settle out with all the weight that'll be in the water tank. So the next part of this installation is the aquarium pump. So we've got our packaging here. Again, this is a submersible style pump, so it'll sit inside the tank, so no need to drill holes in the tank. This part is the pump. There's a nipple connection right here. We'll screw on here, and that'll connect directly to our vinyl tubing. And this electrical cord will come up over the edge of the tank and out. This will screw onto our pump, like so. And we will set our pump down on the bottom, mark where that cut's gonna be, and then we'll use our cutters. And we can go ahead and cut right on that line. Your tubing and your pump might be a little bit different size, so this doesn't wanna fit in here very well, but it's pretty close. So one thing that you can do is take a pair of pliers, like needle nose pliers, and go in and force those in there and stretch. That vinyl tubing will stretch pretty well, and if you heat it up, it'll do an even better job of stretching. And then you take this nipple piece and work it up inside of there. Beautiful. Now that we have everything assembled, we want to see if it's working properly. So we're going to fill the fish tank up with water and see what we got here. So now we've got enough water in our aquarium, we're going to go ahead and start filling up these grow beds, and we're going to make sure that our system is working and not leaking too bad. Once the water level gets above the top of the PVC pipes, the air bubbles that are trapped inside will get sucked out of the container. And once all the air bubbles are gone, it'll start a siphon, and then it'll quickly take all the water out of the grow beds. So you have to adjust each one of these accordingly until you get the right amount of flow going through your system. It's a little bit of an art to figure out how much water flow, but you want to try to equal those out as best as possible. Looks like our pump's running just fine. We've gotten here to the pea gravel part. Now this comes out of a quarry where they're dredging out small river rock that's been deposited over the years. And so there's a lot of soil and small particles that come along with that. So we're gonna go ahead and clean up, flush out a lot of those small particles before we put them into the system. That way we prevent a lot of the cloudiness from occurring. So what we're gonna do, we've got our bags sat out here in the gutter, and I'm gonna go ahead and poke a small hole in the top, big enough to put my water hose in. Okay, so I have my water hose here, and then we're gonna put just a few small perforations down along the bottom here so the water has somewhere to go, and hopefully the bags don't rip out on us. That's definitely something to think about. So I'm gonna go ahead and start adding some water here. We have our tank in place, we have water in there, we have all of our grow beds in place. The last part is installing the light fixture. So we measured the distance between our two posts here, which is now 49 and a half inches. And we also have two 12-inch 2x4s that are gonna hold the light fixture in place. So let's go ahead and build that. We're gonna cut us about a 1/30-inch length of chain to replace these short chains so we can vary the height of our light and be able to give the plants exactly what they need. All right, so you can see now our completed system. We've hung our light. We added a 1/30-inch chain to each side. That way we can raise and lower the level of the light so that the plants can get more light as they grow from small up to large. I'm gonna touch up our stain. We're gonna add our pea gravel into each one of these, and we're gonna cycle our system and let our bacteria establish before we put our fish in. Put a little bit of gravel down the bottom. Things to keep in mind if you're putting this inside your home, this is a very heavy system. There's 55 gallons of water here, 8 pounds per gallon, so over 400 pounds of water, and then we're gonna have about 120 more pounds of gravel in here, so very, very heavy. So if you're putting it on a main floor, make sure you put it by a load-bearing wall or put it down the basement under on some concrete or something like that. But you should be able to grow a lot of lettuce and herbs and that sort of thing in here. So this will be a really fun system to have at your home or in your classroom. Other fish species you might choose could be tilapia or barramundi or hybrid striped bass. Or in our example, we're using a hybrid bluegill, which is a mixture of bluegill sunfish and green sunfish. These are very readily available.